one to call. Better shield you from them shields that been killing us all. High beams for eyes to peek the villains in the dark. Power of resolution for a war would even start. The knowledge to build and grow where they live and take care of the kids and the older folk. The queen cause they need it most. Politic with the kings about economic growth. Cure PTSD cause mental health ain't a joke. Feed the hungry and dope. Everyone would know everywhere we go.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. A black superhero. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero. It's gonna take one of us to save us. It's gonna take one thing. I gotta trust me. Just get to keep the faith and know that. Because you got mine, I got your back. I know. It's gonna take one of us to save us. It's gonna take one thing. I gotta trust me. Just get to keep.
I'm alive in the dark, and I keep getting stronger. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible.
Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to. I pull the sword out the border, walk a floor full of cobras. Go to war with you all, we can brawl toe to toe. I can tighten loops in my lace and make lightning lose in a race. I make fire cool and come back from the triangle in Bermuda. I can suit up, live in the moon up, working and outsmarting computers. I can outswim all the tuna, and that's without a scuba. So in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. I can make time traveling a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. Look up and beam to the stars so you can turn off the lights.
I come alive in the dark, and I keep getting stronger. Tonight I hunt with the pride. You can't take my pride away. I can sing with the birds and the trees in the morning, or roar like the storms way over the ocean. My limit's the sky. I do the impossible, impossible.
Shine if I want to. I win every time if I want to. The world mine if I want to. Make the world mine cause I want to.
Even on the days when I'm late as ever, my timing is right. Even in the darkest moments, they close, I'm that shining the light. I can make an earthquake nervous. I can make the sun wear a visor. I can make a wise owl see me as a daily advisor. I'm that cool shade, peaceful night, and still my breath is a storm. I bet I can make the thunder clap when I perform. It's just that in the laws of nature, I'm breaking the rules. Only thing I'm bad at is being a loser. Hey, I can make time travel a surprise. Make graveyards feel alive. Break the immortal down to his demise. I make the moon blue. I'm making pigs fly. Now I move mountains. I would have beaten the heart of a crash test dummy. I'm also astounded. Yeah. Look up and beam to the stars so you can turn off the lights.
I do the impossible, impossible.
Say it with your chest. hit him with the right, then I hit him with the left. Then the juke move, Heisman, stiff arm, lights out, you snooze. Lights, can't prime time action. Run it up, touchdown, I'm snapping. In the field with the plays, y'all mad. It's a mini given Sunday magic. Lights, can't prime time action. Run it up, touchdown, I'm snapping. In the field with the plays, y'all mad. It's a mini given Sunday magic. This is not a game, this is not a game. Banging on your chest when I come through the paint. Never been about the money or the fame. But when it bring both, so here we go again. Wins on the road, yeah, I got those. Couple records that I hold, yeah, I got those. It's the playoffs, the team just got home. We ain't going outside when it matter most. Lights, can't prime time action. Run it up, touchdown, I'm snapping. In the field with the plays, y'all mad. It's a mini given Sunday magic. Lights, can't prime time action. Run it up, touchdown, I'm snapping.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today we've got a good Week 5 matchup in store here between the New York Giants and the Green Bay Packers. The first quarter of the season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in Week 5 on EA Sports. Now it's Allen. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. But that last throw, Charles, puts him over 15,000 yards passing now for his career.
And Brandy, they're not going to stop the game and give him the game ball here, but that's still a pretty impressive number. And he's got plenty of more good football ahead of him. Although I would say the team should give him a game ball after it's all over.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now the first carry for Cam Akers. Give him maybe a yard, quite the opposite from the previous big gainer. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. On play action, Allen. The Packers had 2-2 through the first 4 weeks of the season. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
They'll run on first down with Akers. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
The last run good for 2. Here's second and 8. Forward by Allen on the jet sweep. And he is going to lose yardage here. The defensive coordinators love that. You got a cornerback willing to stick his nose in there, come up on run support, and stop that pop pass dead in its tracks.
And partner, one good thing about trying to defend that play, you should see it coming the whole way. You see the receiver coming in motion in your direction. Nice job eluding the blocker, making the play behind the line of scrimmage, but an even better job studying the play before you have to try and defend it in a game.
So they fake the handoff. Now Allen. Hard throw, incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Zerline's kick is up and through, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted, though.
Yeah, but bottom line, they wanted to get something out of that drive, and they did that. 3 points, they won't turn that down at all.
After the made field goal, Zerline back out there now to send this one away. fields this way up at the 17. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 24. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25. So this matchup, the second of three games in London this year. Vikings and Saints were here last week, and then the Broncos and Jags. They'll be at Wembley at the end of the month. Plus this year, remember, a fourth European game, our first one ever in Munich, Germany. That'll be the Bucs and the Seahawks, November 13th. On second and 9, Jones. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Give them 18 there, and the Giants have a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And a good pickup there. He gets about six up to midfield. This defense for the Packers, they were strong last week, CD, and that win over New England.
And no matter what's done throughout a ballgame, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles on tape that I saw last game. This team does a nice job of getting their opponents on the ground.
They go back to Pollard on second down. And he's got room. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. That burst good for 20 and a first down. Couple of nice carries back to back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yards you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's Pollard again. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now Jones. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Throwing Jones. He rifles one that's intercepted. And the Packers are going to take over once again at their own 25-yard line. Thought he had the pick. Flag comes in for PI, so cancel it out.
Interference. Oh, a killer for them. Thought they had a nice play. Instead, they'll be marching off yardage against them.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, 1st and 10. Now a timeout called for by the defense. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now a give here to Pollard. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of one there. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Three nothing after one on EA Sports. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Looking for Tate, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Kirby Joseph, and the Packers are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one? Or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
He'll let this go deep for Sutton. It got his man complete. And he's going to be taken down at about the 33. So there is the big arm of Josh Allen on display. He can throw it as deep as anybody, and that was an absolute laser. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That second down play, that's a minus four. They went with the run pass option, and I don't know if the option really mattered there because the defense was ready.
So many times you put the defense at a disadvantage because you have those multiple options, but when they read their keys and play it correctly, sometimes the result goes in their favor.
He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
This defense not fooled one bit on that touch pass.
And this has become one of those kind of in vogue plays, you know, kind of like the shuffle pass was a few years ago. This one never got off the ground, but you understand why a lot of teams are running it. These wide receivers, a lot of them, they run like running backs with the ball in their hands.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
Their partner guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Again, they'll throw with Allen. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Harold Landry drops him for a four-yard loss there, and that brings up fourth down. Zerline's kick is up and through. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal here.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
Fielded right around the eight. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They find themselves down here after an interception on their opening drive led to a field goal. But all in all, you'd have to say fortunate to be only down six.
Yeah, and you know how teams huddle on the sideline before they come out on the field in between series? Guaranteed what's said there is, guess what, guys? We take this ball, move it downfield, put it in the end zone, we're right back to even.
Now Jones on first and 10. Has this complete to Daniel Bellinger. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Call that a very strong gain of 24. Back to throw. Jones. Another pass complete to Bellinger. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. On second down, it's Pollard. He's got room at the 30. And he's going to get this inside the 30. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake. Jones. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
On second and 10, Jones looking for Mims, but this is intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Bobby Wagner. The 30! And what a return as he brings this all the way back down to the 20-yard line. The struggles continue here offensively. Still nothing for him on the scoreboard, and now an interception.
Yeah, the offense looks extremely sluggish, not really in sync at all. Dare I say, it looks like it got left behind in customs.
Oh, you've had that in your back pocket. You were waiting for that.
Probably should have left it in my back pocket, too.
Well played. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Running from the shotgun with Madison. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you got to continue to try and run it, try and keep the defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5. And he is going to lose yardage here. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
So here's Greg Zuerlein now as he'll try for the field goal. It'll be from the right hash, and it'll be a 36-yarder. Zuerlein's kick is up and through, and that will make this a 9-point lead. So the interception set him up with terrific field position, but 3 points, the end result.
Yeah, we can make this one pretty simple, partner. You always want to end drives with points, but that's one that you're going to look back on and probably say, we should have done better there.
Fielded right around the 8. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they...
Oh, Jones has just thrown his third interception. picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And the Packers are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line. Well, Charles, you know, so close to halftime there, you throw the interception. Not only that, you do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy.
So after the INT, it's Allen. Open man here. It's the tight end, Kelce. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This will be, let's see, 38 yards out. Zerline's kick is up and through, and that will do it for this first half. So we come upon halftime in what's a 12-point game at the break. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, and we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. Fields this way up at the 17, and he'll be stopped up at the 25. Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. By no means, certainly, are they out of this contest. Two-score game, start of the third quarter. But you feel like if they don't get points and then they give up points, then it can become a slippery slope. This feels like an important possession.
Yeah, and that slope becomes even more slick if you come away empty-handed on this drive, because then you give them a chance to extend their...
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
And that has to be a little bit discouraging, because after all their halftime talk, adjustments, and points of emphasis, their first drive ends with an interception. Absolutely aggravating if you're a head coach, because you spent all that time, gone through every situation possible, and it still ends in a turnover.
On play action, Allen. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Rashad Evans, the linebacker, recording the sack there.
I'm sure a lot of time was spent in the locker room, Charles, talking with his defense about setting a tone here in the third quarter when you're down on the scoreboard. Sack like that, maybe that can get him going.
Yeah, you have to believe exactly what you just said. They got together and said, let's be some change agents here. Let's go ahead and turn things around.
And this is caught. Touchdown. A.J. Brown, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Packers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Oh, I was just about to say he hadn't missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Taken in at the 3. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Looking to throw, Jones. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And a terrific return there. They're finally able to corral him down near the 11-yard line.
Well, there's two sides to this coin. I mean, on one side, five interceptions now thrown for him. That's tough. But, man, this defense, they have been ball-hawking and impressive. But, Charles, let's flip it back over. If you're coaching a quarterback that's struggling this much at this stage of the game, do you maybe try to get him out?
I would think about it, and I think about it awfully hard, but also, you might want to look into his eyes, see what he has. He might be one of those players that you don't want to affect his confidence by actually pulling him out of the game.
Allen hit. He lost the football. And who's got it? The Giants! And they had just picked it off to get the football. They fumble it right back. I looked over at both sidelines. A lot of scrambling to find the helmets.
Yeah, you can almost, I mean, you know both sides are screaming sudden change. Because when sudden change happens, that's a defensive call to get back out on the field. There's been a fumble, so an interception, some type of a turnover. You've got to get back out there and play. These guys just want to get to the bench and gather themselves and regroup a little bit. Let's see if these offenses can settle in and start taking care of the ball a little bit better.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20. 55 rushing yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. Good push up front in that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Jones on first down. He's got Bellinger. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. It'll be a handoff to Pollard. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Back to throw. Jones dancing to his left. And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. Off play action. Jones. And now here's another interception. He's at the 50, 30, 10, and into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown.
Well, I mean, you get it. They're trying to make something happen here in this third quarter, CD, but I don't think a pick six is exactly what they had in mind.
No, not at all, because this offense, they've been stuck all game long. Haven't dented the scoreboard yet. And they're kind of forced to take a few chances here. And that one, it backfired in a big way.
Zerline now for the PAT. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. Get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. A short kick taken at the 18. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here, maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
Here's Jones on third down. He's letting this one go for Fuller. It's caught inside the 25. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And the Giants are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. Run for Pollard. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Now a timeout called for by the defense. And with that, they're down to one remaining here in the second half. Second down and goal. Jones. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Daniel Jones, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Giants are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the third. And oh, it's wide right. No good. Out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're 3 scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in 2-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, 4-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, 2nd and 10 from the 25. They'll go Madison up the middle. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. offense on third down, they've only converted once in four tries. This will be third and six. Now Allen. Flushed out right. Pass to Brown. He's got it on the crossing route. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Packer first down.
Well, normally you might say start running the football. You've got the lead. But the way that they passed it with such success, I don't know, maybe keep throwing it.
Yeah, I think you brought up something that goes against conventional wisdom, right? In this stage of the game, you would think you would switch to a running attack, but you're exactly right. They've thrown it so well throughout the game, and trusting this quarterback, I think he continued to do so.
Here's Madison running on first down, and they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. And I think we can get used to seeing more of that in this fourth quarter, especially if they're having success on the ground like they did there.
Yeah, I think back when we met with the head coach in preseason, and all he talked about was building a bully. And I think it was this situation he was envisioning, trying to ice a game, plenty of time left, but being able to give the ball to his big runner and pound away and try and finish off a game.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it at them. We've got them now.
And now here's a deep shot that's complete. Touchdown, Packers! Travis Kelce, 46 yards. And the Packers are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets a head of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
With Madison, and he's going to be hit and taken down in the backfield. Just nowhere to run that time, and the try for two is snuffed out. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Fielded right around the 8. And able to get this across the 20, but
let them see it. I'm the first to say it, now it's time you just believe it. I got too many fakes, made lots of foes, these people cold. Talk down your dreams because they know they can't come close. Don't shake no hands, they'll steal your friends, I walk alone. I see false idols, all the titles, you need to grow. I've lost your mind, but I ain't like the others no more. God, I'm learning lessons as I go. You're only wasting time. Tell the devil there's a door. Praying God is only trying to tell.